Good afternoon. This is Pastor Tim, and we're going to talk this afternoon for just a few minutes about practical prayer. You guys have been praying all day. We've been doing no food and lots of prayer, but right now we want to talk about how does this prayer thing look? Sometimes you ask the question, what do I do? How do I pray? How do I communicate with God? Well, let's talk about that for a few minutes. First thing I want you to do is I want you to get your Bible, if you don't have it already, and turn to the Gospel of Matthew chapter 6. While you're turning there, I want to tell you what it says in the Gospel of Luke chapter 11. The disciples asked Jesus a simple question. They knew Jesus was a man of prayer, and they simply said, Jesus, teach us how to pray. And he did. And the model that he used is the same one you're going to see here in the Sermon on the Mount. But first, a couple of cautions. And I'll show these to you right out of the Gospel of Matthew as we start. Got your Bible? It says in verse 5, first thing, don't be like those hypocrites. What does that mean? Well, people that just show up on street corners and try to gather a crowd or pray really loud so they can be heard really well, don't do that. Other thing, verse 7 says, when you pray, don't just blah, 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 Not, it says a heap of phrases, empty phrases. Don't just talk. Spend time with God and communicate with your Father. So I want to show you a simple little tool. And you've all got one of these, so I want you to use it. When you look at the Lord's Prayer, which is right there in Matthew chapter 6, there are five things that I want you to see, and I'll quickly walk you through them. When you think of the Lord's Prayer, you can probably rattle it off in your head really quick. We have it in our memories, but let's look at this. Okay, first of all, our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. That's this thumb. This thumb is set apart. Hallowed means holy. God, you are special. You are amazing. Hallowed be your name. Then next, your kingdom come, your will be done, not mine, on earth as it is in heaven. That's a big command for God to do what he's going to do and for me not to worry so much about what I'm going to do. Next, give us this day our daily bread. Give us what we need. That's important. And forgive us. We need forgiveness from God, and we need to forgive others. You see this ring on my ring finger? This reminds me about relationship with my wife. That relationship's not going to go so good if we don't have communication, and part of that is forgiveness. I need to forgive her when she needs forgiveness. She needs to forgive me. We need our Father's forgiveness. We need to be in touch with him with that important aspect. And finally, this one, it says, do not lead us into temptation. Deliver us from the evil one. That's what it says. So, Milt, why don't you come up and give us a few musical tunes, and then we're going to practice this prayer.
Let's sing together. Our Father, right in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Come and let your glory come, and let your glory fall. Our Father, right in heaven, the rocks cry out your fame. Come and let your glory come, and let your glory fall. I will sing a new song, I will sing a new song, I will sing a new song to the Lord. Let your kingdom come, let your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Every heart will claim the mercy of your name, on earth as it is in heaven. Thank you. God give us new every morning. Mercy is daily bread. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus we pray. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us with your hand. Just believe what you say, yeah, yeah, you're and let you give your life to me so I might live and share the hope you gave to me. Love set me free. Amen. Tim, come on and lead us in a prayer now.
Get out your prayer guide, and let's use this little memory tool, not just this afternoon, but whenever you're thinking, Lord, it's time, let's spend some time. Think about these things that Jesus taught his disciples. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Think about your favorite word, name, for God right now, and say that to him. Think about your God who is above all. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Not my will, but your will, God. Think of the things that you need. God cares about those things. Give us today our daily bread. Give us the things we need. Tell God what you need right now. Remember in Jesus' lesson to his disciples, one of the first things he told them is, you guys, God knows everything you need. He knows before you ask. But ask him. He loves to give. Lead us not into temptation. Deliver us from evil. I forgot that one about we want to be sure that we're being forgiven by God as we ask and we confess to him. We're forgiving others. Don't forget that one. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Amen.